Hello and welcome to Supreme Commander Forge Lines Forever. Today, a bit of a different cast. We're going to cast all of Nexus of Realities games from tournament. Legend of the Stars number 4 qualifying tournament. And it's a tournament Nexus 1. Spoiler. And he had a very difficult bracket. He went through the winner's bracket and had a lot of good players. And the first player he had to take down was Mad Mozart as Angus McFife. Don't know what that name means. It's Mad Mozart. So we're gonna do a bit of an experiment. And we're going to stay in Nexus's point of view and see what it does and try and see what its playstyle is and how he works. So this map is Hilly Plateau Ultimate, one of Cookie Noob's Ultimate maps. Not his map, but made changes to it so that the mexes are kind of optional. I'll put a link in the description for should explain the ultimate maps, and basically it's just a really configured map, different number of slots and so on, different amounts of reclaim, optional sieves and a lot of stuff. So Nexus is going third air. It's a big map, so he's gone for a lab on third air, and he sees Mozart's also lab. So labs are definitely good, because you really want to make a lot of engineers at your first factory on this map, because there's so many mechs to grab, so much reclaim. So more engineers, this means better eco. So he's gone second land, first factory. Don't know if he made any units out of it, maybe two, other than the lab. And he's just gonna get the second factory up fast. So his land units there to defend. His lab didn't, but it did spot Mozart's lab. It's quite useful. And force Mozart to defend with the Mantis rather than just running that Mantis straight across. Mozart is moving extremely fast to the middle. That has been spotted, that's very important. The ACU is early on. If you spot the ACU early, you can usually tell where it's going to be for the next 5 minutes, pretty much. So, first spotting the ACU is another important factor is all these Hydras. Definitely want to grab all those as fast as possible. Hydra is just much more efficient. And T1P gens and has higher HP to boot. So, more factories going down. He has reclaim, so can afford and needs to build factories. Stops building P gens because he had enough power at the time, and now he got a bomber out. Perhaps this scout can find a target for the bomber, and does in fact, that's exactly what it does. You can see, has the scout already in place, bomber comes out, and he queues up targets while the scout is overhead. So this bomber probably has 2, 3, 4 targets. Over here we have Mantis and scouts. Sweet Mozart are actually micering pretty nicely, but killing the scout, which is quite a big deal. You can see how much harder it is to actually know where to put your units once that scout dies. Bit of a lack of power. The Hydras are just a bit slow in my opinion. And Mozart, I think it's been in mid for a while, but it seems like all the reclaim is still there. for Nexus. There goes the first engineer. He already has another target lined up. And he's gone. But Nexus are almost all completed. And oh, that's a nice drop. You see these new bombers can do some ridiculous things. Now he does have to be careful here. He's in mid, yeah, trying to make a PD while the commander is shooting it. It's not gonna work, but he doesn't have radar. So Altair could be just rallying every single unit to mid and have like 20 units here and just kill Nexus immediately. So now we see a scout going forward. He has to be careful. See, he's already worried about how many units Altair could have with him. It's a pretty good PD to defend some reclaim, secure it a bit. But the back expansions are basically fine for Nexus, and he has done a little bit of damage. Not so much damage as just slowed down these back positions for Mozart. More T1 land coming up. Just gotta keep building factories when you have mass in the bank. It's quite a spread out map, so there's a lot of mexes to grab and a lot of mexes to deny, so T1 land, just adding more T1 land is pretty good. Now he sees an opportunity to take quite a bit of HP off the commander, so he goes for it. And you can see now he has a 3k HP advantage on his commander, which is not something to be ignored. These air scouts are giving great coverage because they don't actually have a radar here, so air scouts are needed. And looks like he will be able to cut this out without doing too much, if any, damage. So what's the plan? We might see commander upgrade. We see more factories going down. He still has a solid amount of power and enough mass in the bank to throw down more factories. Now we see a T2 mech done and a couple T1 mechs. More air being added because he has the power to accommodate that. And again, the spread out mechs mean air will be quite useful. And we don't see any. Don't see much air from Mozart, and we don't see any anti-air. Now, a lot of Mozart spam is just going straight to mid, so Nexus definitely has to be careful here. PD to retreat to be a good option. It's not great for Mozart to have two PDs here and then also have basically all the spam. It's kind of doesn't really need the PDs now. I would expect in this position that Mozart is getting a commander upgrade. His commander fell back and hasn't been seen since, so that's what he should expect. Now we see Nexus actually going back to base. No, he's not. He's just retreating slightly to get T2. Definitely a good choice here. This raid could be good. Still see there's all these little tiny bits of reclaim. Would definitely be a good idea to be drop NGs, drop one to each point and get them reclaiming. That would be very nice. Here we have T2 air. It's not going for T2 land, instead going for T2 air. I'd like that choice. Should be able to deal with raids. Also raid himself with T2 air as long as he can keep air control. Now looking at eco, he has the eco lead. You can actually see that these two are raiding. As you would expect, Mozart should know that he is behind an eco. Here these mantis are sacrificing themselves to T1 PD, and T2 should be complete. T2 upgrade is pretty nice. He can get TMD, which will defend basically his full base from TML. And Can also defend this T1 spam with some PD. T2 PD. So, what T2 air units will we see come out? We see Corsairs, okay. Not many Inties for Nexus. Don't expect him to have more than Mozart. So we'll have to see what he can actually do with these Corsairs. And they have actually been scouted by Mozart now. Or T2 Air Factory has been scouted. And he may have seen Corsairs building inside. Looks like Mozart wasn't actually getting an upgrade, he was just retreating. That is a factory that's going to T2. You can tell by this little thing. And also, actually, it looks as though there's two factories. Well, you can actually see that it's T2. That is interesting. So TML from Nexus, definitely a good choice. In for some mexes. There's no TMD here, he's just scouted. Commander under attack. Doesn't actually queued up any targets, unfortunately. Over here, it's just kind of T1 spam, but just trading, nobody really doing much damage. Walls are definitely advisable on this map. Mozart has no T2 land. He's also gone T2 air yet, as we saw, but now it actually shows on the radar as a T2 HQ. And there's no T2 land from Nexus, so that means no flak yet. So he's definitely vulnerable. He could afford a shield. Well, he really needs another T2 PGM before he can build a shield, to be honest. Definitely something he should consider getting. And so should Mozart. Three Corsairs out now, and he switched to Indie Production as HQ. Unsurprisingly, does have some spam issues to deal with. Fortunately, no upgrading mexes that could be killed here, but gonna lose a Hydro. In terms of T2 mexes, he has 9. You can see Mozart has 1, 2, 3. It seems like just 3. So, yeah, Nexus should definitely like his position and just continue investing in T2 support factories, maybe throw down more PDs to defend this T1 spam on the sides, and also get his commander safe. You see he's retreating now to his base, and this T1 spam is just never getting through these PDs. 22, 29, 18. Really need to get a lot of your units bunched up and then get the Medusas in to stun Cerberus turrets. Medusa are very good versus Cerberus turrets because stun them and stop them firing, and that affects units with a high fire rate much more than others. So that's why Loyalist stunning Perseus is not so good. It basically doesn't affect their DPS, but it will. It is good for not allowing Perseus to retreat. It doesn't really affect their damage output. Whereas if you stun Bricks with Loyalists, you affect the damage output quite a lot. Gunships coming in, there's some T1 anti-air, quite a bit actually, so retreats. And now this T2PD. Can't shoot, has no vision. That's a dead T2 mech, so I think that got TML'd. So we probably see T3 land. Yes, it's on the way, and then Loyalists, and he can probably get in behind. Certainly kill anything on the sides, clean up any annoying raids. Most base mechs is now T2. Lots and lots of air Oh, four Mozart. That's a hell of a lot of indies. In mid, still tons of T1 spam. It's not really doing much of anything. And the eco lead is still there. It's another dead mech, so I think that probably got TML'd as well, did it? These gunships are very annoying. Just out and about, getting in the way. So we'll see T3 land. Nexus will try to not lose air. And oh, he actually made some T3 mobile A. It's a bit weird. All this T1 spam is not gonna. It's not really done that much for Mozart. It's they're not gonna do anything anymore in the game. So we should expect T3 land from Mozart. Probably from a new factory, so that it can't be seen on radar immediately. Something going on here. Okay, we see Corsairs, don't know if Nexus has spotted them. He's adding P-Gens so he can add even more shields. He should not leave his shields at ED1 stage. Only 4k HP, it's not very much. Especially if a Corsair comes in, it'll probably hit both shields. He is upgrading them now, so that's a good move. Should have some flak around, I guess. T3 mobile A, it's nice. And yeah, now he definitely has to see the Corsairs here. No T3 land, this is an all-in snipe. He's loyalists. I mean, 7 loyalists to stop some T1 raid is not great. Stop the raid, doesn't really matter what happens at all. It just matters that he survives the snipe and then it's game over. You don't need to worry about attacking anywhere. If he just continues making T3 land, he'll have far more units. So just survive the snipe, and yeah, look at this. It's a lot of shields he has, a lot of anti-air. There's no way Ceres could kill him here, firing like. So let's speed it up. And yeah, he should not send these out, because Corsairs will kill them all. He should definitely have bringing like 5 flax with this army. That should probably be enough. It's unlikely that the Corsairs can snipe all those flax. And he doesn't want to fight air. The worst thing would be air over nothing and then lose air and have just hordes of Corsairs coming for the ACU with no indies to attack them. He did try and catch those Corsairs, and actually it looks like he can win there. No, in fact I don't think he can. So this is not good for Nexus, not what you want to see. Don't know why my frames are so bad. And now he has anti-airs with this army, so he can send them in, but there's actually loyalists built already. And Nexus salvages some of his air. I think Mozart should have just killed all of that, in my opinion. Now let's see what the anti-airs can do. They don't have any. Don't have any scouts with this army, so they can't actually use all their range. But yeah, we do see Corsairs dying there. Quite a few. The air scouts are nice, allowing anti-airs to target Corsairs. And we have bricks, which now. All this dead air is now being reclaimed. And he's just gonna shoot with the loyalists. He does need to run in back here. He probably can't do enough damage and he would just lose the loyalists. Here come Corsairs sniping three surrounded mexes. So that's quite interesting. I guess he really doesn't believe he can snipe the ACU. And now Nexus sends in his air force. It's pretty small. More importantly, he sends in the bouncers. And we're gonna farm so many kills. He really needs to just run a radar here so he can actually use the range of his anti-air. And there's the loyalist drop. That's pretty nice. The T2 transport didn't have a move order back, unfortunately. But he can get some kills. Look at those Corsairs just got vaporized. So much mass dumped around Nexus's base. And these four bricks look pretty deadly. I don't see any units here. TMD goes down. See some TMLs launched then. There goes T2 PGen. And the Corsairs are going to come in and try and defend with the Loyalists. And it should be successful. Two bricks down. And the air sent in. Try and snipe some of these Corsairs. So we lost a lot of eco here. Quite a lot. And it's not being replaced. As in, first off, these aren't being rebuilt. But also, these are not upgrading. Oh, I'm wrong. In fact, he's already upgrading two of those. And this one's almost done. And this one has begun. Now, he started making RAS. And I think he changed his mind and decided to make a P-Gen. This guy is assisting the SU, but not actually anything. 18 bricks out now. That's huge. Can't imagine Mozart has anywhere close to that number. And bricks. He's keeping them all together. He doesn't have them spread out all across the map where they could be easily caught out by a larger group of loyalists. If you keep them out in groups of 1, 2, and 3, then suddenly you can just have 10 loyalists appear and kill them very quickly. And the bricks have no chance to retreat. But here, another raid. These mechs has just been remade into T2 and they're gonna die. But we will see another dump of mass, but that's still pretty good kills. And now a push up here. He's gonna apply a lot of pressure, and that's just gonna basically, even if he can't win, which he very well could, there's a ton of bricks, but even if he can't, he basically forces every unit produced to stay in the base. There's no way he's gonna be sending stuff around the sides when there's 11 bricks walking into his base. Now the Corsairs are drafted, but wow. These anti-airs have huge amounts of kills. They have vet, they're regening HP, they have more HP than they started with, and they're not going to be easy to snipe. He's actually dodging quite well with them, so they're not even really taking damage. And the Corsairs are all just getting popped very quickly. Can he even focus down this HQ? That would be a good target. Looks like he just doesn't even need to focus it. It's gonna die nonetheless. That should be GG. And actually, we have a spider bot complete, but I think it's just slightly too late. The HQ is down, that's a huge blow. Could actually try and target fire it. Running away. Yeah, the problem is with running away is that the spider bot will come out of vision radius, and then the bricks start turning away, and then when it appears back in the radar, he has to turn back again. Probably better to just target fire, see how much damage you can do. And if you really try hard, you can just control K whatever brick he's aiming at just before it dies to deny veterancy. That is some extreme try hard. 18 bricks out. No XP for Nexus, doesn't need it. He's making T3 air instead, and it looks like he can probably just strap on everything. T3 mexes at the back for Mozart. Pretty amazing. And actually the bouncers are escaping and killing mexes on their way out, because they do have that auto toggle, they can shoot ground units. Trying to steal some reclaim, but he's just gonna feed some vet to this monkey lord. Does have one vet level. But these bricks should easily deal the monkey lord, and there's not gonna be any other T3 units because they're all dead and HQ is dead, but that is a mega that's almost complete. And Nexus only has a spider bot himself, so this is actually very dangerous. Now, with bricks and loyalists, you can abuse the fuck out of experimentalists. So I would love to see some loyalist abuse, or the most OP unit versus these ASF have basically no chance versus so many inties. They're just not very useful. Building strap bombers could be useful, but ASF wise, I mean, not actually building any. He's building them now. Mega is complete. The spider is complete. This mega is blowing up now. We don't have any T3 mexes. No, I'm wrong again. We have 3 T3 mexes for Nexus, 4 for Mozart. So, let's see. I feel like Nexus' army is just going to be far superior. This mega shouldn't take too long to build, but an Omni right now would be. Also, he gets a lot of T1 mexes across the map. You can see Mozart is basically confined to this area. There's no mexes outside of it. It's a nice advantage to have. Just gonna retreat, allow his megalith time to build. Mozart is just farming a bit though, trying to get some damage in on these T3 tanks. Get a bit closer to a vet level. There's an Omni from Mozart. There's his ACU. Don't see a T3 HQ, T3 land HQ, just see T3 air HQ. So how do you micro versus this? Well, the first thing you need is vision. You have to be able to see what's going on. Then you need to group all your bricks. And group all your loyalists, and the ideal thing is to get stuns on the XPs. They're actually boat retreat. Isn't really much they can do versus basically 2 XPs and a whole lot of T3 when there's just 2 XP. We should probably see and expect another experimental because there is no T3 land production. Mods are actually building two at once. Not advisable, really. And Nexus is pushing. He is not adding any more experimentals, interestingly enough. And I'm not sure where his megalith is headed. And he's just gonna spread the loyalists everywhere. Okay, he's found the megalith, and it's actually seems to be split from the monkey lord. So you need more scouting to understand if you can actually exploit that. Well, that seems to be the megalith using the terrain as a shield. It's just gonna escape this way. And there is the monkey lord. So just retreating to the base. Oh, that just upgraded T2. It means this one was like 99% died. More T3 P-gens. Coming, this would be so nice. See, T3 P-gen and then another XP. It's monkey. Oh my god, the megalith is so close to the monkey lord. And oh, it's not shooting. Laser. There we go. Maltark's monkey shows up in time. The bricks are in range. Another spider bot. Spider bot is completely dead. I'm not sure why this megalith is running even closer. Maybe it should walk over the bricks, maybe. Oh my god. There it goes. This spider bot will also go down. Has a higher damage output, but there's just enough bricks here. The Mega has enough HP to tank. And that should be game. Don't expect this Mega to complete. Now the Mega will move in, and actually, you should probably just throw down one of these things to allow you to. Megalith will super fast reclaim it. If you place an egg on any reclaim, it will move to reclaim the wreck to make room for its egg, and it reclaims at an insanely high speed, so just one of the silly advantages a megalith has. And what's our calls? No snipe. Yeah, Maltar wanted the snipe, but Nexus just, he had the shields and was upgrading them, and Maltar in the end didn't even end up going for the snipe. Just did some damage, killed some mexes over here and here, which was kinda good for him, but ultimately the Corsairs didn't really fully pay for themselves. And then once those bricks got in and killed the HQ just in time, just before the spider completed, that kind of sealed the deal. Nexus just had to play the game out at that stage. She did quite well. So let's go to next game. I don't think I'll cast every game in the tourney in one video. Might be a bit much. Probably do it in two parts. So let's go to the second game. This one is versus Blackheart. PC Blackheart. Uncertus Major. So classic map. Map everyone's played. I've played 1v1, and yeah, map with lots of reclaim, map with mid reclaim and lots of tiny rocks, and a map with a lot of history. Rip Tourney Dreams. So, Blackheart actually not feeling confident apparently versus Nexus. Interesting. So, Blackheart has not qualified for the end of year tournament. He hadn't before this tournament began. I don't think he played any of the other qualifying tournaments. So, he's just left himself one chance, which was this tourney. And it is double elimination, so in losing this game he can qualify. But Blackheart saying he's not confident going up against Nexus, which is interesting. Don't think normally describe Blackheart as not confident. Have you seen me play? No. Okay, so we have it's a lab. Okay, interesting. Mantis first, and then two labs, and a scout. Not sure why you do. Probably just go all labs. Maybe like first five labs, just to run straight across there. You go for the build order, you make a couple of mixes, assist the Hydra. So if you like finish the Hydra, you don't assist any more of the P-Gens, you just go straight over, build the slime factory as fast as you can, and send labs straight across, then that's probably pretty good. But they're already defending it. There's Mantis in position. So then you'd have to micro ever take this. It's like maybe he can when he is. Well, these are Mantis, in fact, I think. And these are the labs just run in and die, so it's not gonna work. I think you need to send the Mantis in first, and then start microing the labs. So the labs pretty big mass stall here. But really it's actually just pretty good balance. I mean, not enough mass, but if he had more mass he wouldn't have the power for it. So it's definitely time to be adding P-Gens. Air factory paused, unfortunately, before there's doesn't have any air scout to work with. It's two inties. And not many units on this side at all, so relying on the scout to give him enough warning. Maybe he should move the scout up further to give him just a bit more warning for units coming this way. I think this radar is not that useful, to be honest, and he doesn't really have much power. And there it goes, he turns it off. Because as you can see, it's just basically stuff he already doesn't tell him anything too interesting. I mean, if he had it up here, then he at least knows how many units are in the direct vicinity. So now he's seen with that air scout, or he should have seen if he was paying attention. Quite a few units. Rakar has brought Mantis and Medusa here. He's already working on the Auto Gateway in mid, which is the source of most of the mass in middle. This is a nice raid. Always good to raid this position because it slows down this reclaim. Killing two mexes and denying them is nice, but all of this reclaim is the main thing that you're slowing down. On top, just the small amount of units he had is just getting overrun. He's been power stalling for a very long time and never solved that problem. Which is really, it's really bad for him. It's the reason he's so far behind. He never fixed his power problem. Now he's losing air. Blackheart just sends his air in and finds the Nexus's inties small number he actually has and just kills them all. X is just lucky that Blackheart hasn't killed this position. No spam sent this way. Now Jester in here, just adding insult to injury. I don't think Nexus can die here, but I don't think it's too dangerous. But he's gonna lose a lot of HP over here. Like I was saying, it's gonna slow down the reclaim. Although Nexus has grabbed quite a bit of it already. He's gonna slow it down and kill these couple mexes over here. We have Jester is just gonna raid whatever it can. Yeah, it's gonna retreat to here and kill this mex probably. And now we do have quite a bit of spam. We have these anti-airs coming out, it's a good decision. Looking at Blackheart's base, we can see three T2 mexes. Nexus has just one now, so he knows he's behind an eco and starts mexes immediately, try and catch up. Right now he is just clearly behind, so it's time to, you have to understand when you're behind that he spots a drop here, to understand that you're behind and change your play to try and correct that. So he's gonna move to T2 land, get some engies out. So what can he do to actually bring this back? Well, he needs to do some damage and he needs to be as efficient as possible. So there's positions that are contestable that he should be trying to get, and also there's a reclaim that he should be aiming for. So these mexes, this reclaim, these mexes and this reclaim definitely be trying to get. He desperately needs some vision here. Oh my god, he gave the order and looked away. He he looked away just before that radar was done, so he didn't see the army. That's a really big army for Blackheart, and there are a couple Medusa in there, but not really enough Medusa that he can just run willy-nilly over PDs. So PDs should have end, but this is stalling really hard, trying to get this T2P gen done, but simultaneously trying to get this PD up. PD does get completed. The Medusa, this PD was not shooting. It started. Pretty sure that was not shooting for quite a while there. And Blackheart just retreats. He's forced 1, 2, 4 PDs. It's basically 1,000 mass forced with that push. Also forced like 6 or 7 NGs to be building a PD while Nexus was trying to build his T2 PGen. So that hurts. TMD going up. Mex is being built. Got 1, 2 grading at halfway. Looking over Blackheart, we can see 5 mexes complete. Perhaps 1 or 2 of these at the back are done as well. But can't know. On the right, he has grabbed these mexes, wants to defend them with a PD and try and grab some reclaim. TML's coming in. What was there? He killed something there, but he's aiming for the mechs, but you just can't TML this mechs. Can't really TML this mechs either unless you're TMLing across, which is not exactly likely. On the bottom, T1 spam just runs over this position as soon as Nexus has taken it. The PD was not quite complete. So the T2 land hasn't done anything so far. Well, it's a drop from Blackheart. And that's another drop from Blackheart. So he can do some good raids here. This is a T2 mix. That dies, that's gonna be really painful. Up here. Nexus, huge power stall again, just as this PGen is finishing. That's a T2 mech as well, really? Oh, this hurts. That's pretty greedy there with these T2 mechs. Another drop. This Corsair might be able to just kill them all when they drop. Did he really just try and ground fire? That is so ridiculous. There's really no need for that. This drop gets cut out. Reclaim here, he's missing. So yeah, losing the T2 mix is pretty nasty. And there's T3 land from BC Blackheart. And just completed for Nexus. It's T2 land, I mean, if you think about it, I didn't see any T2 land, I think, from Blackheart. And his T1 land successfully did quite well for him. Pushed Nexus back from mid, did some raiding here, won some fights here, took out this position, denied it from Nexus. So, and he didn't make any T2 land, it seems. Not that I've seen. Nexus T2 land is not doing much at all. He's trying to push here, but this is, I'm not really sure about this. Very committed to this fight, and now actually you see T3 and T1 here. So he can probably lose this entire army and just be dumping a ton of mass for Blackheart to reclaim. And the Rhinos are probably also shooting the ground a huge amount, I would guess. Actually, seem to be missing sometimes, I'm not really sure, but either way, most of that army is dead now. Here we have, this army is pretty much stronger than what we've got in front of us. Should depend on micro Oz. This Rhino just running into the middle is not ideal. I think it took the alpha damage of both the loyalists in Blackheart's army. Corsair's moving in. Yeah, sniping this TML might be good. Or sniping some TMD and TMLing yourself. That would be good too. Well, not TMLing yourself. Using TML yourself. So, small reclaim field for Nexus here, but up here we have a lot of mass for Blackheart to grab. It's just gonna put him further into the lead. Nexus trying his best, just continuing to eco. But this is dangerous right now. He needs to commit T3 units to this position to defend his new T2 mexes or his upcoming T2 mexes. In terms of T3 land production, we have 2 support factories and a HQ, no assist on any of them, barring like the odd T1 engineer. These Corsairs have not done a huge amount, mostly just defending drops and did a little bit in this position as well. He just gave a bad move order there. Things I don't like here is the complete lack of stealth. Stealth is really nice. This brick is, that's a really nice drop. And you should be able to kill every T2 mechs here. Actually, it's T1 mechs. But he should be able to kill the 3 T2 mechs. And perhaps that's even upgrading. And the bottom, he has to be careful not to get trapped and overrun. This is a... basically his entire army in the south of the map is this. Here goes T2 mechs. T1 mechs goes down as well and the brick dies. Off-map air fight going on. Don't know what the fuck. Off-mapping is so... units that are off-map are just so weird. But this army is... looks in a bit of danger. Rhinos are gonna die pretty quick. Over here, he also forced a ton of units back from the front. I wouldn't... My T3 units... exposed like that with no radar, he should retreat to where he can see. Another drop, this is a stealth drop. He won't actually get the second kill though. If you're stealth dropping, you should just drop the brick and just continue recycling. The deceiver, just leave the deceiver in the transport all the time. This attempted push is surely gonna get cut out and just leave more reclaim. Over here, he's making this army count, just staying alive for the same period of time, forcing a huge amount of T3 units to be over here rather than pushing here. Maybe if this army was pushing with the rest, maybe he could break through, maybe he could win a fight here. As it is, he doesn't, and he takes a bit of damage here. I don't know how quickly he can retrieve the reclaim, which I'll see. Max is getting surrounded, getting capped. And we have a drop going to happen, perhaps. This one is loaded. So we have 13 Corsairs. See some scouts. That's a T3 mech. T3 mechs. Two T3 mechs from Blackheart. No such decadence from Nexus. And there's a lot of scouting. 13 Corsairs. 4 transports with T3 units in them. 2 bricks and 6 loyalists. Seems as though Blackheart has never made any bricks in this game. Just pure loyalist spam. Despicable stuff. Despicable. So let's see what's gonna happen here. 13, 14 Corsairs. You know, that's not really that many Corsairs, but 8 T3 units are getting dropped, and I must have surely seen the ACU here. He's not sure about dropping, but there's not enough flak. Looks like these are all gonna drop. You see Blackheart under a couple of shields. Oh, there's no dodge whatsoever. All the Corsairs are dead. Oh, Blackheart gets a vet. He was under 2k, he's just 3k now. He bumps the loyalist. He needs to get under his shield. And single brick left. Oh my god, he just bumped into his loyalists so he didn't get under his shield. He would survive otherwise. Oh my god. Well, that was a good snipe from Nexus. But I mean, first off, you can dodge basically 100% of Corsair damage from the first pass. You can dodge everything because they're all grouped up and stuff. And, yeah, you can dodge, let's say 90%, basically every time. Blackheart didn't dodge at all, and most of the damage he took there is not from the T3 units, it was from that first pass of the court. But then, just bumping into the loyalist as he's trying to get under his shield, it's horrible. It's horrible. Well, one Sam in your base is pretty much a good idea, in my opinion. If you're winning, you want to build shields around your ACU, that's good. Build one or two Sams in your base is even better. Hey, I think Nexus got outplayed there pretty completely. Except for the end. So Nexus moves on to the next round. Blackheart even wasted mats. Probably wasted some in mid or something, I guess. Okay, well, I'm gonna leave it there and continue casting the rest of Nexus games in this tourney in